This demonstration will show you how to perform dimension modeling with DBVA. So we start from a very simple ER model. We got the ER model for the sales order system in here. We got the order and the product, and there's an order table, which is the order line actually. And we got the shop and the customer. So you can see all these entities are organized under the ER model. And now let's try to start create a dimension model. Now we create a new ELD and assume this is the about the sales. Like this, the sales fact model. And now we got the, for example, the time dimension. And in here we got the, for example, the time key, which is the ID, and day of week, month, just like this for the moment. And we create another entity for the product. The product dimension, and we insert the column, which is the, for example, product key. And the brand, like this. One more, we got the, for example, store dimension. And here we got the store key address. Yes. Like this. And now we create another the table, which is the key one here, the sales fact table, like this. And now we just need to drag out the relationship in here. Assume this is like this, and you will see you got the time key in here. Now let's do it again, and we will generate the column for you. Like this. Okay. Now, actually this naming pattern can be altered and by specifying in the option dialog. ORM and then the synchronize. In here. Yes, in here you can specify the foreign key pattern, but I just leave it here first. So you can see you've now got the dimension model for the sales fact. And okay, this is the first step, and the most important is why we have the ER model and the dimension model in here, because we can model the trace between the relationship between the ER model and the dimension model. And suppose we create another ELD like this and name it as the trace of sales fact model, like this. And we can do it like this. We copy all things, put it in the sales fact model, and we paste the wheel only. Now in here we got this identical diagram. And now we go to the ER model, and for example we drag out the order. Now we got the order in here. And you can see the time key actually is come from the day of the order, so we can create a generic connector to link up the order and the time. And you can press the pin connector to pin it here like this, and we pin the connectors. like this one. So it indicates the time. The time dimension actually is come from the order, the time here. And for example, we drag on another entity, the shop. Because this relationship is appear in the YAML model, and so it will generate by default. We can simply delete this. And yes, and actually the underlying relationship will not be removed. You can see it's still in here. Okay, now we create a relationship between the own shop ID and the dimension. And again, we pin the connector like this. So now I show you the store key actually is from the shop ID. So you can always trace where the fact model comes from. And okay, one more thing is because we are using the DBVA is using a shared model approach, so you can do it we use the model in different diagrams. For example, we create another dimension model called the customer fact model like this. And this time for we create an entity for the customer dimension here, and we got the customer key name like this, and assume we will also have assume is just this and the customer. This you then drag out the relationship in here, then you got the customer key in here attached that. So for example, we have another one like the product. If we use the product dimension in here, just drag it out, and then the create a relationship, generate the key. So now you got another fact model related to the customer and the product he purchased. So it's very simple to perform the dimension modeling with the DBVA.